So we'll move forward to registration requirements under the MSMED Act 2006. So if a person want to start, the MSME enterprises, so according to the MSMED Act, so a person, any person as per the Act, if they want to intending to establish any enterprises, they have to follow these things. So that is what. So they need some formalities. They need some registration requirements. So what is so according to this act only it is formed. That is, a micro or small enterprises may at his discretion. So at what is your level? As I told just now, explained that one. So according to the investment, so it has classified. So according to the discretion of the discretion of it is investment, it is classified. It may be micro or small enterprises. Next, a medium enterprise engaged in providing services may at its discretion. So it may be medium enterprises providing its services. What is its discretion? According to its discretion, it may be classified. Next, a medium enterprise engaged in the manufacturing. So if medium enterprises which is engaged in the manufacturing enterprise of goods pertaining to any industry specified to the first schedule to the Industrial Act, that is 95, Industries Act 1951, according to that it has discreted, according to that it has discretion. So here the medium, according to the industry, any industry, it may be any industry specified in the 1951 Act. So according to that, a medium enterprises engaged in manufacturing of goods and services. Now next we'll move forward to the what is the significance of MSMEs, significance of importance of MSMEs. So here MSMEs provide lot of benefits to the entrepreneurs, for the micro enterprises and small enterprises and medium enterprises. So they will provide lot of benefits to them to establish the enterprises. They will provide lot of provisions, and they provide a lot of subsidies, the finances to establish, for the encouragement of these and these persons. They provide lot of things. So here with that they have MSMEs have lot of significance, lot of importance in our economy, because they will provide lot of benefits to the country's economy. Here when we spoke about the MSMEs, when it comes to our India, 8% of GDP comes from MSMEs only. 8%, because in India we don't have a large scale industries, only we always depend upon the micro and small medium enterprises only. So with that, definitely 8% of GDP comes from MSMEs only. So in that 45% of manufacturing, it provides the 45% of manufacturing output. So even though we have very less manufacturing output, in that 45%, you can see that more it is up to half of the share of manufacturing output which lies in MSMEs only. So MSMEs gives 45% of our country's manufacturing outputs, and they will provide 40% of exports also. The products which we export to other countries, so 40% are with MSMEs only. So in MSMEs only they will provide 40%. Next, it is one of the largest, it provides the largest employment after the agriculture. In India we can consider it as in agriculture only most of the individuals are employed. So after that, next to that, MSMEs only provide the employment. So this is after that, they are the largest largest provider of employment. MSME provide largest employment, and it is MSME, as I told, it will encourage the entrepreneurs. So you can call it as a MSMEs, it is considered as a MSMEs are nurseries of entrepreneurs, because they will start here. MSMEs gives different types of they will conduct different type of programs for the encouragement of, for motivating of entrepreneurs. So it is considered it as a nurseries, because there only we can get a lot of entrepreneurs. So with the basic idea, they will come out and establish, with encouragement and subsidies given by the government through the MSMEs. So they will establish. So with that, definitely it is with that new types of products will come out, and different types of enterprises will come, and not only that, with that employment can be given. So definitely it is regarded as a nurseries for entrepreneurship, and it is considered as a nurseries for innovations. So different innovations will come, because here most of the youth will come forward when we provide some encouragement, when we give some motivation. So here with that, definitely the innovation takes place, because they will understand the markets, they will understand the customer needs and preferences, with that a new innovation. So that is the reason it is regarded as nurseries for entrepreneurship and innovation. A new product will come from this MSMEs only, and it is widely spread and produce diverse range of products and services. So as I told here, a new enterprise entrepreneurs will take place, and with that it is a nursery for innovations. Here with these MSMEs we'll get different range of products and services. Here new types of products will come into the market, because every time market needs a change, a consumer needs always a change. So definitely we have to observe. So with that only, that is possible only with these MSMEs only. So here we can get the, here consumer can enjoy a diverse range of different types of products and services. There will be a diverse range of products and services, and to meet the, it is not that only local markets only we can take. Here as I told, we can export also, 40% of export. So you can, according to the global consumers also, we can satisfy the global consumers. So we can enter into the global markets also with the help of this MSMEs. So when we have that wide range of, when we have the innovative products, innovative services, so we can satisfy not only local markets, and we can go to the global markets also. So it will satisfy the needs and preferences of global markets also. So we can go and we can enter, we can conquer in the global markets too. So that is what the benefits, that is what the importance of encouraging this MSMEs. So here MSMEs have the separate ministry also. So here the ministry of MSMEs initiated lot of programs. They are undertaking lot of programs for the skill developments, for the encouragement of entrepreneurs. If you have any basic idea, so they will provide the financing, they will provide the finance to you. So in the different types, they are giving lot of benefits. So they have taken number of programs are there actually. And not only that, if we have any idea, you can contact directly a National Institute for Entrepreneurship and Small Business Development. If you want, so if you have an idea but you don't know how to build an enterprise, so you can go and you can contact these persons, these people. So they will help in each and every aspect of the business. So that is what it will give. So if we provide that pushing, if we push the people providing different facilities, so we can improve, we can develop the MSME enterprises. So here so those kind of programs are undertaken by the Ministry of MSMEs. So they are taking lot of programs for enhancing the skills of youth, and with that they are motivating them to start their own enterprises. With that, because when we when MSMEs will grow, definitely the country's economy will also grow, because they are the major players in they will provide 8% of GDP. So that is the reason they are encouraging more and more MSMEs. So here we learn about some of the in India, how they have MSMEs are, how they are following, what are their requirements, and we'll know about the significance of MSMEs understood. When we understand these things, so we'll know about the significance, what is the importance of MSMEs. Here, when we study, 90% of MSMEs in India are unregistered. So in India, 90% of MSMEs, they are unregistered. So you can call it as a most of them 80% of in 90% 80% of are doing sole proprietorship business only, sole proprietorship firms only. So they are unregistered, actually they are not registered. So when they are registered, they will get these subsidies. But most of them in India, 90% of MSMEs are unregistered only, because they don't know, the ignorance or it might be uneducation, they don't have education, that is the reason they are unregistered. But we have whatever enterprises we have, the most of them 90%, you can call it as a 90%, they are MSMEs only in India. Next, 40% exports are in India through MSME channel only. So we'll 40%, as I told, as I specified, 40% of exports through MSME only. So here, through this channel only the exports are taken, because what are we exporting to another countries, so that is through with the help of MSME channel only we are doing. Next, as I told, 40% employment opportunities, they will provide 40% of employment opportunity after the agriculture sector. These MSMEs only providing lot of employment opportunities only. So if we take overall percentage, definitely they are providing 40% employment opportunities. MSMEs provide 40% of employment opportunities. Next, provide opportunities. Next, MSME provide opportunities to the budding entrepreneur by providing various channels of investment opportunities. So they will help the entrepreneurs also, they will provide the entrepreneurs also, and they will give the investment opportunities also. So if you have any person is having any idea, so the other person who have the money also, so here MSMEs will give the opportunity for the investments. MSMEs will give the opportunities for investment through various channels, by providing various channels of investment opportunities. So that also they will give. Next, MSME provides a good market for the foreign companies. So it will provide a good good market for the foreign companies to start venture capitals in venture capital business in India. So when foreign business people, foreign companies will come, they will come with their technology, they will come with their infrastructure, so that will come to in India. So in that sense, definitely MSMEs plays a very vital role. They will give the opportunity, they will provide good market for the foreign companies. With that, the foreign currency will come, with that our economy will grow. So that is how it indirectly benefits to the country. So here MSME has very important role in providing a good market for foreign companies to start a venture capital business in India. In that sense, definitely it is very helpful, it is benefited also. So this is what the significance of MSMEs.